everyone, and welcome. Today, I'm excited to walk you through our new inject code functionality within Frontend, our VS Code extension that transforms Figma designs into reusable code components. In this demo, we'll be using a Figma file to inject a new component, a new form, within our existing project. This process will automate the generation of React and CSS code, helping save time and maintain consistency for our developers. Let's start by opening a Figma file. Now, you can see that I have a very simple form design, which includes a header and the form itself. So if we look at the different Figma components that are comprised in this Figma design, we'll see an input field, checkbox label, and a button that are appear over here in the design. There's also some variants and error messages for handling invalid inputs. This setup is very typical in many web applications, but we're going to enhance it by injecting a new reusable way to create forms. All I need to do now is copy the Figma link and open it up in Frontend. So I'm just going to copy the link and open VS Code in an existing project. You can see I already have a working project here. I have an existing component called input field, and I just want to pull it up in Frontend. In terms of the conventions, I want to use React and JavaScript CSS using the Material UI library. So now all I want to do is take the link that I previously copied and paste it into Frontend and press View Code. What we can see here is that Frontend has opened up the design. If I go to the subscribe to Frontend frame that I had in Figma before, what you can see that Frontend is doing is that it's analyzing the Figma file and matching the components between my existing code, Material UI, and the design to corresponding code components that we can reuse in our project. Okay, now it's finished. We can also change between visual accuracy and code quality. I'm going to use code quality, and what we can see here is that Frontend was able to match my local input component, input field component, you can see it here. And the other components that the design uses, it's taken from the Material UI library. We can see that also here, because it was able to match, you can see the screen circle means that it matched. What I want to do now is take this entire form and create a new component of the entire form that uses both local and Material UI components to have a fully functioning subscribe to Frontend form. So what I want to do now is press the inject component button. Once I press this, you'll see that I have several options. I can choose the name of my new component. I'm just going to leave the default. I can choose the path where it's going to be. I'm going to use the source folder, so the default. I can choose whether I want to download the assets that may be used in this component. And I can select if I want to inject the style guide. That's the style guide CSS that will be used in the project. And it's going to generate the subcomponents that it was that detected. So I'm going to go ahead and press generate. You can see I now have new files, subscribe to Frontend JavaScript, which is the main file. And if we open the source file, the source folder, we can see I have my input field from before. And I have a new component called subscribe to Frontend with all the assets that it needed, the SVG files, the PNG, the style CSS, and of course the JavaScript itself, while the style guide CSS file is located here below. The first thing that I want to tweak here is that since we're using a local component, Frontend has injected it under source input field, which is correct, but it's better to use relative fields. So what I want to do here is just change it to be relative. And what I want to do is check my localhost to see, whether this worked or not. So let's go ahead and open it up. My localhost looks like this. So it's very similar to the original design. There are a few changes, which I'll talk about. But what I want you to see is that I have a fully functional field. So I can fill up the email field. I can also accept terms. You'll see that it says accept terms, and I can press the submit button. Now, in this version, we don't support local theming yet. It uses the Material UI theme, but in the very near future, we're going to also add support for local theming. And that's why you can see that the text here is in black except terms, and my buttons, which the button should have been white, is now blue because that's the general default material UI colors. So if we want to change this up a bit, what I would need to do is go back to my code, and where it says accept terms, for example, I can change the color to be white. And I'll pull up the localhost again. And you can see now the color is white. If we want to change the buttons as well, we can also play with the CSS locally itself, but we can also just change the colors here. So we talked about the button being blue because that's the default primary button in Material UI. If I were to change this to secondary, for example, and pull up localhost again, you'll see that now it's purple. So this is how fast and easy it was just to generate a fully functional form using Frontend. I hope this was helpful. You're more than welcome to give us feedback, comments, or questions. Send them our way. I hope this was helpful. See you next time. Bye-bye.